In this question, we're trying to find out how many ways we can pick two columns, which don't touch, and two rows, which don't touch. I'm going to start with the columns. And I'm going to find out how many when we pick the left-hand column first, and then pick the right-hand column. So if we pick this first column as our leftmost, then we can't pick the one directly next to it. But we can pick any of these remaining five. Then if we are starting with the second column as our leftmost, again, we can't pick the one directly next to it. But we can pick any of the remaining four as our right-hand column. Continuing on like this, we'll see that if the first column is here, there's only three options for the right-hand column. If the left-hand column is here, there's only two options. The left-hand column is here, there's only one option. And there's no options if the left-hand column is in the final two positions. So we can continue this with 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. So the total way of picking two columns which don't touch each other is 15. Okay, we can repeat this idea for the rows, which there's far less of. So picking the top row to be at the very top gives two options for where the bottom row can be. And picking the top row to be the second one down gives one option for where the bottom row can be. And then finally, there's no options for the other positions. So the rows, there's 2 plus 1 is 3. Now, how we pick a column doesn't affect how we can pick a row, and how we pick a row doesn't affect how we pick a column. So these are independent and we can multiply them together. So the total number of ways of picking is 15 times 3 is 45, and that is option A.